We are a specialized building construction company with a specialization in super high rise. We are constructing amazingly marquee projects, including the Trump Tower, which is about 304 meters tall. So we can talk about what we do. As far as financials are concerned, the company grossed a revenue of about 1140 crores for FY17, with a PAT at about 69.5 crores. And given the order backlog of about 4,600 crores, we do believe that the momentum will continue.
Also, sir, demonetization kind of hit the realty sector in November, and that was a period that kind of did reduce the number of, you know, projects that were being sold because of the cash curb. But your revenue rose by nearly 35% from 2016 to 2017. So how did you manage to do that, and what led to the rise in the revenue?
So firstly, I believe demonetization must have hit people from the unorganized segment. If you look at our order book and the quality of the client we deal with, whether it's Loda Group, Abroy Construction, Godrej Properties, Brookfield, and so on and so forth, including Brigade, a prestige from South India, they're absolutely well-established players with good corporate governance at in their respective companies. So obviously, when we execute projects for such clientele, our revenue taking a hit because of our aspect of demonetization doesn't arise. So that's what we intend to continue. Our entire order backlog of 4,600 crores comes from these marquee clients, and as such, these small parameters of demonetization, RERA implementation, basically will only improve the client quality going forward. So that's the reason why we could achieve the revenue what you were just mentioning.
Also, when we talk about some of the other regulations like RERA, for that matter, although it does not impact your company directly, but the clients that you have, those would be affected directly. So what kind of an impact do you see of RERA on your own company? Would the prices that you seek from your clients increase, or how would things change post RERA for you?
See, this is a very dynamic situation. As far as we are concerned, we are as good as the quality of our clients. And when, as for the sake of repeating, if you go through the list of our clients, these are very, very marquee clients. So why would our basis of estimation change when the client quality does not change? What does RERA do is it seeks to bring transparency for ultimately the consumer. And something which is good for the consumer has to be good for the contractor, which is we, and also for the financial institutions. And in long run or midterm, we believe it will benefit the good organized developers also in a big way.
What exactly is the working capital cycle like when it comes to your business?
So firstly, my receivable cycle, including retention, is 90 days. So it is not 30% of my order book. It is 30% of my revenue. More specifically, we can measure it as part of the number of days to revenue. So it's 90 days. And if you reduce the retention part from that, it is 62 days, which is a very, very fair level to have. Going forward, as and when the RERA gets implemented, things improve, the economy doing better, we do believe there could be an improvement of 8 to 10 days, but this should not be taken as a commitment. So we will see how things pan out further. But to clarify, it is 62 days after reducing retention from the overall receivables.
Also, I do understand, Mr. Katyal, that most of the business, especially when it comes to construction in India, is with contract laborers than with organized employees. So, however, the attrition rate has somehow gone up over the years for your company. Do you plan to bring that down, or what would the business model be like? Would it be more contract laborers versus employees in the company? How would that work out?
So our company is 5 years old, all right? So obviously we started in 2012 end. If you look at the number of employees from a 10-member team, today we are 1700 plus team. So when you have such a team, obviously attrition will be there. At the senior level, we believe that our attrition levels are extremely good, very, very low. The second part of the question is the contract labor. We have close to 10,000 workmen under various subcontractors who are working at the various project sites spread across the country. Managing 10,000 workmen on a consistent basis year after year, it itself shows that we are providing the amenities and the requirements which are required to retain such level of contract laborers or contract workmen under subcontractors. So the attrition rate could be related to only our permanent people, our engineers, and as I told you, that in a fast-growing company, which has 1,700 people, there is bound to be some attrition. We don't see that as a challenge at the moment in time.
So as I understand from the proceeds, 250 crores would go into the working capital requirements and another 50 would go into purchase of new capital assets. What else would the money be utilized in? If you say it's general corporate purposes, would you be able to tell us how exactly would those proceeds be utilized?
So general corporate purposes include many aspects of the business which at that moment in time cannot be projected. You have suddenly a bigger order and you require some resources for that. So obviously, as you rightly mentioned, 250 crores is a sizable portion which is getting into long-term working capital, which obviously would improve the already very, very good net working capital cycle that the company has, and also would bring down the cost of purchases and therefore pushing or bettering the other parameters of the balance sheet. Now coming to the other corporate purpose, as I told you, this will be utilized basically for growing the business of the company, all right, for certain expenses which cannot be foreseen at the moment at the corporate level. And obviously the overall working capital of 250 crores plus 75 crores of corpus of general corporate purpose would go into improving the long-term business prospects of the company.
So also when we talk about the future of the company, you've already expanded and talked about expansion into certain places like Hyderabad, Kochi, Pune, and I think Kochi project has already begun. So how else do you see the company growing? Because currently more than 50% of its projects are concentrated in Mumbai. So would it remain to be like that, or do you plan to expand more towards south or the other zones?
So we are already present in seven of the top cities in the country. So Mumbai MMR is a bigger geography. The concentration of urbanized population was higher. So obviously the projects were more. And more so that the company started operations from Mumbai. If you look at South India, where we are working in Bangalore, Hyderabad, Cochin and Chennai, where all the projects have started, obviously the percentage of South zone has increased and gone up to 23% of the order book. So on an absolute basis, that's a substantial increase, and that would continue. So we are currently focused on these seven cities, including Pune. And obviously we will look at places like Ahmedabad and other geographies over the next three quarters. But currently, given the momentum which we have from these geographies itself, I believe we are quite happy with the order book we have.
Is there any sales target that the company has that it is working with, especially when it comes to these different zones? What would be the kind of sales targets that the company would have for the next year?
I can give you what we have. We cannot give any target, obviously. What we generally are focused on is the quality of the client. And that's what is exhibited from our order book. And that is very, very critical for us. And that would remain as the predominant decision taking when it comes to going to new geographies. Generally, we go to new geographies with our existing clients. If you look at Bangalore, we had Purvankara who took us to Chennai. We had Prestige who took us to Cochin. And there is Purvankara again who took us to Pune. So if we have existing clients who have or come up with projects in a new geography, we will definitely look at that. But a new geography on its own in totality would take at least two quarters from now, given the already existing robust order book we have.